वेलकम स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम अगेन टू माय न्यू लेक्चर। आई एम मोहम्मद तनवीर अहमद, लेक्चरर डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ सिविल इंजीनियरिंग, वर्ल्ड यूनिवर्सिटी ऑफ बांग्लादेश। आउटलाइन ऑफ द लेक्चर। इन दिस लेक्चर वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ सॉलिड वेस्ट। हियर वी ग्रुप द प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ सॉलिड वेस्ट इंटू थ्री टाइप्स। दे आर फिजिकल प्रॉपर्टीज, केमिकल एंड मैकेनिकल प्रॉपर्टीज। All these properties will discussed in this lecture. Besides, we will calculate the energy content from solid waste by ultimate analysis method. In previous lecture, we have discussed about energy content, and here I am shortly saying again that energy content is the energy that we can be obtained from a solid waste by burning process. Physical properties. First, we will discuss about physical properties. Physical properties comprises a density, moisture content, size distribution, etc. So, our first property is density. Density is the mass occupied by a unit volume of material. That means mass of a certain object or material whose volume is one unit. Why density is important in solid waste? First one, maybe a high density volume waste capture system can be reduce the volume in a solid waste management, significantly reduces the cost of collection, transportation and final disposal. That means if the density of the waste is high, it can occupy maximum payload capacity of the vehicle and can thus reduces the transportation as well as collection cost. Then if the waste has high density, non-compaction vehicle can be used, and on the other hand, if the waste has low density, compaction vehicle need to be used, and thus it can reduces significantly the cost of transportation. Moisture content. It indicates the percentage of water present in a waste stream. If we read, we can see the ratio of the amount of water present to the total weight of waste material for a given waste stream is called moisture content. The percentage of moisture content is in solid waste is generally determined by one of the following equation. First one is moisture content, and that is weight-weight method. Weight-weight means percentage of water compared to its weight compared to its weight, and can be determined by the following equation: 100 into WW minus WD divided by WW. Here WW equal to weight of sample, WD equal to dry weight of sample. Then moisture content can another way to calculation is dry weight method, and dry weight means percentage of water compared to the dry weight of the waste, and the equation is 100 into WW minus WD divided by WD. Here WW and WD is also the same as above. So by this way we can easily calculate moisture content. Size distribution. Waste material generates from various sources and their size may vary. So depending on the size, we need to select waste collection bin. But sometimes the size of the waste is so rough that it will be difficult to contain the waste into the bin. This is similar to the waste collection vehicle. To overcome this problem, we need to distribute the size of the waste into a smaller and easily accessible one. Generally, size distribution can be measured using manually manipulated screen and reported as size distribution curves, which represents cumulative percentage of the matter passing through increasing size, increasing screen size. chemical properties. First one belongs to chemical property is ultimate analysis. In ultimate analysis, it is an analysis used to ascertain the percentage of each element present in a waste sample, and that is the main objective. So we can say the main objective of ultimate analysis is to find the components present in the waste. Generally, it involves to find out the percentage of constituents as shown in the table below. That means that shown in the table in next slide. This table shows the percentage of 5 common ingredients or various constituents present in a sample of solid waste by ultimate analysis, and this data is represented by percentage of weight in dry basis. Here these are the components of solid waste and these are the constituents of solid waste. Here the first 5 common name, that is carbon, hydrogen, oxygen and oxygen, nitrogen and sulfur, and these are the major part or major elements of ultimate analysis, and using these 5 elements we can calculate energy content from a solid waste. And if we sum all these 6 elements or 6 items, then we will get 100% mass. For example, of food waste, if we sum this carbon, percentage of carbon, hydrogen, oxygen, nitrogen, sulfur and ash, we will get 100% mass. Similarly, for paper, if we sum this 6 item, we will get 100% mass. Similarly for others, this data has been adopted from Kaiser in a research that was conducted in 1978. Here the first 5 components, the first 5 elements are the major constituents. Sometimes ash needed to be analysis in case of heavy metals because it may pose significant environmental problems for the ultimate disposal of ash. Proximate analysis. Proximate analysis is used to evaluate the combustion properties of solid waste and to determine the possibility of its use in combustion system. That means to justify the potential of the waste to use in combustion is the main objective of this analysis. Then it frequently involves the determination of moisture content, volatile combustible matter, fixed carbon and ash content. The material having the lowest moisture content and maximum volatile combustible material indicates high potentiality to use the waste as combustible material. That means if the materials have low moisture content and high volatile combustible material, it is most suitable to use as combustion system. This is the proximate analysis and calorific values of solid wastes. These are the components, and this 4 item comprises the proximate analysis by percentage of weight, and these 3 items are calorific values, that means energy content. For example, we can say this paper mixed item, the first 4 items represents proximate analysis, and if we sum these 4 items we will get 100%, and we can get energy content from mixed paper as collected 15,750. As collected means the waste collected in natural state, and if we dry this waste we will get energy more than as collected, and that is 17,530, and as moisture or ash free 18,650. This is mass more than other 2. and similarly for the other components. This data is also taken from Kaiser. Fusion point of ash, and this is the temperature at which the ash resulting from the burning of waste will form a solid clinker by fusion and agglomeration. That means this is the temperature at which no solid waste will remain as raw material and all items of solid waste will transform into ash at this temperature. Generally, the typical fusion temperature for the formation of clinker from solid waste range between 1100 degrees Celsius and 1200 degrees Celsius. And within this range of temperature, fusion points completely occurs. Energy content. Generally, the energy content is the process to justify material to use it as fuel in combustion system. The energy content can be determined by bomb calorimeter and estimate by Dulong's formula. The formula is stated here. Energy content unit will be kilojoule per kg equal to this one here. This represents the amount of percentage of carbon dioxide. H represents the percentage of hydrogen, O represents the percentage of oxygen, and S represents the percentage of sulfur. So if we know these four items, we can easily determine the energy content. Now we will perform an example. This example is to determine the energy content of the sample of solid wastes. Let's read the question. Determine the energy content or value of a typical sample of municipal solid waste. That means we have to determine the energy content from a municipal solid waste, that means MSW, of 100 kg. That means the total weight of municipal solid waste is 100 kg with the average composition as shown in table 1.3 below, and the composition of solid waste has shown in this table. If we see this table, food waste components is 32.5%, so that means food waste covers 32.5% of total wastes. Similarly, paper mixed way covered 35% of the total waste and other data as shown in table. From this table or using this data, we will calculate the energy content. And to determine the energy content, we need to use this formula, energy content kilojoule per kg. By using this formula, we will calculate energy content from this example. To determine the energy value for each of the constituent of municipal solid waste, we need to use this equation, energy content kilojoule per kg equal to this equation. And in this equation, if we replace the value of C, H, O and S, we can easily calculate energy value. And the data of C, H, O and S we will get from table 1.1. This is the summary table showing the results. That means after calculation of energy content, we have replaced or placing the data in this table, and this is the final table that need to be calculated. Let's see one of the calculation, food waste, that how the energy content of food waste becomes this value. Let's see. This is the sample calculation. and all the calculation of other materials will be same. Energy content for food wastes equal to, this equation is taken from above, that means this equation just replaced here. Here the value of C, A, O and S has taken from table 1.1 as stated here, that the value of O, A, S, C will taken from table 1.1. So this item is food waste. For food waste, what are the value of C, A, O and S? Let's go table 1.1. This is table 1.1, ultimate analysis of solid wastes. Food wastes, value of C 49.1, value of A is 6.6. Let's replace this value, C equal to 49.1, A is equal to 6.6. Look, C is replaced by 49.1, A is replaced by 6.1. Similarly, O and S, let's again see what are the value of O and S. The value of O for food waste is 37.6 and S is 0.2. Let's see. And the value of O is 37.6 and S is 0.2. And from this equation, we can get energy content for food waste equal to 19,342. And this value has just represents in this table by calculating from that equation. Similarly, we can see the calculation for paper mixed. Let's see the calculation again. Energy content for paper mixed, kilojoule per kg, same equation. This is the same equation, and we have to replace C, A, O and S from table 1.1. So let's see again table 1.1 to pick the value of C, A, O and S for paper mixed item. This is table 1.1 and this is paper mixed item. C equal to, the value of C is 43.4, A is 5.8, O 44.3, replace and S 0.2. So again C 43.4, A is 5.8, O 44.3, S 0.2, and we need to replace this value in that equation. C 33.4, A is 5.8, O 44.3 and S 0.2. And replacing this value, we can calculate energy content for paper mixed item is 15,072 units kilojoule per kg. And so on. Similarly for other calculation. No. So when you will perform this math, you don't need to see or write all the calculation. That means all calculation, that means you don't need to see all calculation of the constituents. You need to see first one sample calculation. That means you need to see only one calculation, or you can see total calculation, but if you write the total calculation, it will be time consuming for you. So I will advise you to write or see only one sample calculation, and then by using calculator just input the value here in this table, and so finally we have done our desired calculation, that means energy content. And this is the energy content for individual components. We can see individual components, each and every individual components energy content have been calculated here, and the calculation of total energy content for a composite solid wastes, that means if we calculate the total energy of these constituents of solid wastes, so what we will need to do, we will discuss how to calculate the total energy of a composite solid wastes in our next lecture. So that is the end of our today's lecture. Thank you everyone.